What's up, y'all? I'm Hurricane. I've been a huge Persona fan for over a decade, so I was extremely excited to hear that Persona 5 Scramble was coming to the US under the name Persona 5 Strikers. I got the digital deluxe edition so I could play it early and give you guys some tips for playing. These are going to be tips for the game overall, not just combat. I'm almost 40 hours into the game, and I promise there will be no spoilers. So, in the words of Joker, let's do this. This is less of a tip, more than just something you should know, but Persona 5 Strikers is an actual, legitimate sequel to the original Persona 5. The story of Strikers is amazing, and it's so just awesome to see all of our favorite Phantom Thieves reunite and be, you know, just themselves. There is only one ending in this game. This isn't like the mainline Persona games where there's bad endings and good endings and true endings. It's only got one ending, so just choose whatever dialogue choices that you want to and no worries as to if it's gonna affect your ending or not. In combat, use and level up everyone. The combat is not like a traditional turn-based Persona game. It's set up more like Dynasty Warriors and more hack and slashy. You choose four of your party members at a time and you can switch and play as all of them. You do not want people to be severely underleveled in this game because the combat is, it's hard. Let's just be honest, it's challenging. And you will need them all for different affinities and whatnot. Do I have like four that are kind of my mains? Yeah, but definitely don't let everybody else fall behind or you will regret it. Level up everyone's master arts. Master arts are unique moves and combos that each character can perform. Each character has four of these. Once you unlock one, you pretty much just do it over and over again until you've, say, mastered it. And then you unlock the next one. These master arts can strengthen your character significantly, and learning them can also just help you understand the combat of each character better. The Velvet Room works a lot differently this time around. It's definitely a more condensed version. So Lavenza will just kind of tell you what you can and can make instead of like choosing a persona and seeing what combinations you can come up with. There's really none of that this time around. It kind of threw me off at first, but you get used to it. One cool thing though is that you can level up your personas with what are called persona points. So that's nice because your favorite personas or your really good ones can stay up to par with your level. Bond perks help a lot. Bond perks are this game's replacement, kind of confidence. Bond perks are permanent upgrades to combat, the store, and even more. Every time you hang out with your friends, you level up one character's master arts, proceed in the story, and more. You get bond experience, which turns into bond points. You could spend these bond points on bond perks. And you know what? Here's the five that I suggest you start investing in ASAP. The first bond perk that I suggest for you guys is Oracle Recovery. The combat is hard in this game. Oracle Recovery makes it so that Futaba will restore some of your HP and SP after every battle. This helps significantly because you battle constantly in this game. This perk is 20 bond points, which is a lot more than the other ones at first, but it is definitely worth saving up for. The next perk is Ambusher. Ambusher is another perk to help you stay alive. You recover a little bit of HP every time you ambush a foe, so it definitely helps you out. The next perk is Extortionist. Money is hard to get at first in this game, or really in general, actually. It's kind of hard to get, and you will definitely need it for your healing items, weapons, and more. Extortionist raises the money you make after every battle. This is definitely worth your bond points because I spend a lot of money in this game. Bond Maker. Bond Maker actually raises the amount of bond experience you get, which will get you more bond points. This is helpful so you can keep earning bond points to put into other bond perks. And lastly, Metaverse Medic. This perk actually increases the effects of healing items. So for example, the drink that would usually give me 10 SP gave me 16 SP after using this perk. And here's another example of that happening right here. So this ends up saving your items and saving you money. Leave the metaverse when you're too tired. Like really, just do it. One nice thing about this game is when you get to a checkpoint in the metaverse, you can actually just leave without penalty. Time will not pass. If it was daytime when you got up in there, it's still gonna be daytime when you could leave. If it was nighttime when you got up in there, it is still gonna be nighttime. Time will not pass. Leave when your character's HP and SP is getting low, because you can just go literally right back in there fully charged and ready to go. A lot of items and groceries restock. When you go into the metaverse, chances are when you come back, a lot of the items at stores around the city might have been restocked. Definitely go back and buy more food ingredients and SP items. Speaking of which, check all the vending machines around you, because some of them have SP items. The earliest SP vending machine I could think of is near the laundromat near Leblanc. Cook. Cooking is actually important. When you cook, you can cook items with SP healing and HP healing. A lot of meals you cook will also add on other effects when used in battle. So definitely buy your groceries, buy your vegetables, and cook. Lastly, do requests. In this game, you will get requests similar to Mementos quests from the first game. A lot of them have rewards like new weapons, but some of them have rewards like new items in stock at the store, taking off a level cap on a bond perk, and just some really extremely helpful rewards. Plus, doing that can help you grind up levels. And this is my 10 overall tips for Persona 5 Strikers. I am in love with this game so far, and I hope you guys will be too. Feel free to ask me a question in the comments or tell me how you like the game. Like and subscribe for more Persona content in the future, and deuces!